Hello friends, now in this class we will study state space analysis, which is a part of our unit number 5. We are familiar with the control system or any system. In the system we have inputs, we have outputs, and output is controlled by the input, that is called the response or controller. Generally the transfer function are used to define the stability of the systems, but if system have multiple input and multiple output, then it is very difficult to apply the transfer function, and that's why we need to study state space analysis. Before going in the details, we'll go through some basic of state space analysis. The first one is state. The state is defined by the group of variables which define the position of the system. We know in the system there are different states, like previous, the present state, previous state, and next state. Now group of variables are used to represent that states. The state can give the history of the system. So from that previous data of the system, we can predict the next state of the system. Next is state variable. The variable which is used to represent the state of the system, that is called the state variable. Now in the control system we have different state, input state, output state, the response state. Now the variables are, different variables are used to define the state. Generally x of a and r, x is used to define the input, y is used to define the outputs, and generally the h of a and r is to define the response. So that variable are called the individual variable are called the state variable, and it is present in the form of set variable, small set of variables. State vector, it's a vector which contains the state of variable at its element. So this is a vector having the state variables, input state variable, output state variable, and the response state variables. So it is in the form of vectors. So we know the different conventional techniques are used to define the stability of the system, like transfer function, pole zero diagrams. But here, the state space analysis have some advantages over the conventional techniques. The first one, the state space analysis is use only the initial values to define the stability of the systems. When we use the state space analysis, we no need to study the, no need to have a history, past data of the systems. So just by taking the initial values of the system, we can define the stability of the system. Second, more accurate than the transfer function analysis. We are familiar with the transfer function. There we use the Laplace transform of input, we are taking the Laplace transform of output, and then taking its ratio, we get the transfer function by binding pole and zero. We can define the stabilities. It is possible when the inputs are limited, one or two inputs are variables are limited, then it is possible to apply the transfer function. But variables are more than one, then it is very difficult to apply the transfer function and finding the poles and zeros. So in that case, we can have a state space analysis. Third one is, the system has multiple input and multiple output system can be analyzed by the state space analysis. If we have a multiple inputs or multiple outputs, then we can put that input and output in the form of matrices. And we have, if your data in the form of matrices, then we can apply the state space analysis rather than the conventional techniques. Then this system is very applicable for the dynamic systems. In the dynamic system, the response of the system varies with respect to the time or with respect to the state. So in that case, conventional technique fails. Here, we can use the state space analysis to define the nature of the dynamic system. So these are some advantages of the state space analysis, but it has some disadvantages also. So the first one is the system is complex transient. As we are discussing, the state space analysis system is more efficient for the multiple input and multiple outputs. So if we have a number of states, then the number of variable are increases, and that's why the transience is increased. That's why it is complex. Second disadvantage is that it have a more computation. Of course, the variables are more, the states are more, so that's why the computations are increased, and so it will take more time to analyze to define the systems. These are some disadvantages over these advantages. But advantages are more of the state space analysis, and that's why we need to study it.